Thank you. Hi, so I'm Eli Chambers, and this is Tim Johnson. And for our senior project this year, we directed and organized a boys choir. Some of you might remember that there was a boys choir last year, and there was a boys choir many years ago when we were in fifth grade, so we decided to bring that back. For any of you who don't know, in their senior year, any student can choose to do either an internship or a project during their fourth quarter. This was our choice.
So just a few thank yous. Number one, to everybody involved with the internship program at the high school, most of all, Miss Angelo. She put a lot of hard work into making sure that all of our projects come off smoothly. So a big thank you to her. Also to Miss P for all of the support and the many hours that she's poured into this. And finally, to the guys on stage here for dealing with our less than stellar directing.
Please welcome to the stage the Beverly High School String Ensemble and their director, Stephen Smith.
think it's so much fun to see the kids put down their violins and pick up their trumpets or flutes or clarinets and whatever. We're promised to do much more of that. Get all the kids to do the string repertoire with all the beautiful symphonies really requires brass and woodwinds, and we have the talent here to do it, and we're going to do it. Anyway. I'd like to perform Pirates of the Caribbean now, and also I'd just like to say it's kind of a poignant moment for me because there's so many seniors on stage that this is it. This is it for me and our last concert. And, I wonder if the seniors could just stand right now and just recognize. Thank you.
While we're resetting, I'd like to invite Dr. Hershey down to say a few welcoming words.
Thank you. Makes me kind of want to be Johnny Depp. I had to leave early at the banquet the other night, so I wanted to make sure I had an opportunity to talk to the students in the music program and their marvelous teachers. I've been here, this is my fourth final concert of the year, and the quality that we see in our students is a product of the music program that Beverly has hung on to all the way down to the elementary schools. So the community deserves a lot of credit for hanging on to that. As a former math student, I know how well all of these students do in mathematics because the correlation between music and math is incredible. So I really get pleasure out of listening to this. I accuse their teachers every year of making me stay to the end of this concert because they constantly do music I love. I was kind of thinking tonight, maybe I kind of love all music. A person with zero talent, but I recognize quality, I recognize excitement, and I recognize the pride in which these students take their craft seriously. It takes a tremendous amount of discipline, and it is a huge evolution from when they're in the fourth and fifth grade to where they are on stage today. So I just want to say a few words and thank all of their teachers for what they've done, not only the three that you see before them, but the ones who came before. And to the students, thank you for the pleasure you give me every year.
Thank you.
'cause all that's waiting is regret. And don't you know I'm not your ghost anymore? You've lost the love I love most. I learned to live half alive, and now you want me one more time. And who do you think you are, running around leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts and tearing love apart? You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul, so don't come back for me. Who do you think you are? I hear you asking all the To dedicate this last song to our seniors in the group, and while I'm speaking, I would really like to thank Miss Alexis McTaylor, our student teacher who's been working with our groups this year.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Melanie Kirsch. That's Kirsch, not Kirsch, by the way. This year's band treasurer and also the third and final of the Kirsch clan to graduate from the BHS Music Department. How have you enjoyed this spring concert thus far? Well, judging from the jubilant response, you'll just be plain tickled to know that after months of hype and anticipation, the BHS Jazz Band is ready to unveil its latest Radiohead arrangement. Thus, truth be told, this is the Jazz Band's fifth performance of a tune by the iconic British art rock band. While Radiohead is currently basking in the critical adulation surrounding the 20th anniversary of its iconic OK Computer record, tonight's selection comes from the album Amnesiac, which was released by the band in 2001. This bristling mid-tempo track features Radiohead's hallmarks, including deceptively complex syncopation and grooves, mantra-like melodies, and jarring textures from the rhythm section. Featuring improvised solos from Deirdre Masiak, Sam Vegas, myself, and for the first time ever, Aria Soper, here's Packed Like Sardines in a Crushed Tin Box. Thank you.
Hello, BHS Panther music fans. My name is Elias Jonas Chambers, your 2016 through 2017 BHS band co-president. It is my esteemed privilege to introduce the next piece on the jazz band's program, whose origins can be traced all the way back to 1913. You Made Me Love You, like so many pop tunes of the early 20th century, underwent several permutations prior to its arrival in the hands of trumpeter Harry James in 1941. Before then, this heart-wrenching ballad was first heard in a Broadway review called The Honeymoon Express. By 1938, the song had landed in the hands of Hollywood actress Judy Garland, who is most famous for singing the song to a picture of her main squeeze, Mr. Clark Gable. Don't believe me? It's on YouTube. At any rate, it was big band trumpet player Harry James who had placed an indelible mark on this tale of unrequited love with his instrumental take on the tune. Tonight's performance is arranged in the style of James, with lead trumpet R.E.A. Sofer performing his singular solo, while our alto and tenor players substitute clarinets for their usual saxophones. Here now is James Monaco's You Made Me Love You.
Thank you. Before we introduce our last tune of the evening, I just wanted to shout out the seniors. It's that time of year. Everyone's feeling nostalgic. We're all sad to be losing another great class, and this group is no exception. We've got five seniors graduating. Both of our drummers, Justin Cloyd and Jackson Reed. And losing one apiece from the wind section. In the saxophones, Miss Melanie Kirsch on lead tenor. In the trumpet section, Elias Jonas Chambers. And here to introduce the last tune of the night for this group on bass trombone, Mr. Jake Kelty.
Hi. My name is Jake Kelty, PGA golf fanatic and Beverly Boys of Brass tuba player. It is indeed a pleasure for me to introduce the jazz band's final selection to you this evening. After having just been tantalized by the tremendous trumpet pyrotechnics of Aria, your ear canals are in for another blast of sofer brass magic. Here now to perform the solo on George Gershwin's immortally beloved I Got Rhythm, please welcome to the microphone Mr. Jonathan Sofer, as the band is conducted by our student teacher, Miss Kristen Dunlap. Thank you.
Thank you. watching over me, my Lord, watching all night. They're watching all night and day.
Angels watching over me.
Sun is setting in the west. Angels watching over me, my Lord. May my rest be heavenly blessed. Angels watching over me.
Old and years. live a humble Lord. Humble yourselves, or will the bell done drum. Live a humble Lord, live a humble Lord. Humble yourselves, or will the bell done drum. Live a humble Lord, live a humble Lord. Humble yourselves, or will the bell done drum. Live a humble Lord, live a humble Lord. Humble yourselves, or will the bell done drum.
Glory and honor.
Praise King Jesus. Until the day of grace is spent. The old man Adam had never been out. When the sermon commenced, he jumped up and shouted,
I'm singing glory and honor.
Glory and honor. Sing praise the Lord.
Shouting glory and honor.
Shouting glory and honor. Glory and honor.
Domine, no, 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 the gloria, non nobis domine, tuo 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 the gloria, non nobis domine.
Thank you.
everybody. There it is. My name is Timothy Johnson, a member of the BHS Concert Band, Marching Band, and Vocal Ensemble. I've been begging, his words, Mr. Costa to introduce this next piece for some time now, so he was sure to use exceptionally sumptuous language in an effort to expand my lexicon. Here we go. Andrew Boysen's All the Pretty Little Horses is actually the middle movement of his three folk song settings for band. The piece's title, melody, and lyrics all reference the American lullaby some know as hushabye, though the true origins of this music are thought to be of African-American descent. Boysen's setting is richly yet sensitively scored, with exposed solos, chiming percussion timbres, and three-part singing from the entire band. It also retains the gentle and peaceful pacing of the original folk tune, though it comes to an emotionally charged climax at the midway point, as the original melody and an undulating counter-melody coalesce into a brilliant and vibrant statement of hope. Featuring the inimitable Elio Feisch on flute and recently graduated student teacher Kristen Dunlap on the podium, here is UNH composer Andrew Boysen's All the Pretty Little Horses.
four music department supporters. My name is Julia Kelly, and no, don't you worry, I've left my dingle hoppers and snarfblats at home for this introduction. I do hope, however, that you'll come and be a part of our world of this last selection, or more accurately, a part of Aaron Copland's world. Aaron Copland was one of the most storied and respected classical composers of the 20th century. His music is often referred to as quintessentially American, evoking vivid images of expansive landscapes, as well as notions of promise, freedom, and the enduring spirit of our country's founders. Written under Copland's watchful eye in 1985 by Claire Grundman as a present for the composer's 85th birthday, this panoramic pastiche takes three of Copland's most beloved works, Fanfare for the Common Man, Appalachian Spring, and Rodeo, and binds them together into a cinematic celebration of one of his country's greatest musicians. Here now is a Copland tribute.